Blackstone Publishing presents The Root of Riches, What If Everything You Think About Money Is Wrong? By Chuck Bentley. This book is read by Fred Berman. Introduction. Do not wear yourself out to get rich. Do not trust your own cleverness. Cast but a glance at riches, and they are gone. For they will surely sprout wings and fly off to the sky like an eagle. As a child, our family fall ritual was for my parents to take my brother, two sisters, and me to the Texas State Fair. Each year, I looked forward to the beautiful, crisp weather and a full day of experiences that dazzled the senses. In spite of the many forms of entertainment packed into the day, educational exhibits, the new car show, savory funnel cakes, foot-long corny dogs, the farm animals petting zoo and souvenir shopping, I was always in a hurry to get to the Midway. This was the wide avenue lined with carnival rides and games. Between the rides that produced fear or dizziness or both were booths featuring games of skill and chance, hawked by loud music, flashing lights, dangling prizes, and the constant bellowing of carnival barkers. "Step right up, win a prize!" rang through the clatter of other competing noises. Each game operator tried to entice me and throngs of others crammed into the Midway to buy a chance to win the valuable prizes hanging just inside the booths. They would lean out the tents and taunt the passing crowds by demonstrating how easy it was to knock down three milk bottles with a softball, toss a wooden ring over the top of a soda bottle, or shoot a basketball through a hoop that looked close enough to touch. The chance to win a prize caused my adrenaline to rush, and I was eager to prove my skills. My usual modus operandi, or MO, consisted of a brief surveillance of the area, holding on tight to my few allowance dollars as I tried to determine where the odds of winning were in my favor. Most of the booths were decorated with gigantic stuffed animals. Dogs, gorillas, snakes, and sharks hung tantalizingly out of reach. Some of the grand prizes looked larger than me. After scouting the entire venue to sort through all the options, I would then select three or four places to take my chances. Sometimes my choice was determined by the prize. Other times, I pragmatically chose a game I thought I could win easily, regardless of the prize. I vacillated between the lure of winning a major prize and simply wanting to feel successful at something. Every year, the results were the same. Whether I won a prize or not, I would always lose my money. Worse, I was enticed to lose even more. If I sunk only one of three basketballs into the hoop and two out of one, I was handed a plastic comb or a tiny stuffed animal that could then be redeemed for another try at the grand prize. In other words, I either lost or got the sucker's prize to entice me into risking even more money for the big prize. What looked like a game of skill was more like gambling with the odds stacked in favor of the house. Not surprisingly, my early adult years were spent walking through a real-life Midway, seeking out and taking my chances with a variety of ways to get rich quick. Not only do I regret the vast number of mistakes I made in these failed attempts, but I regret even more the time that was spent so foolishly. Like millions of others, I sought to blaze my own trail to riches. All the while, I fed on a steady stream of books, tapes, and seminars that promised to make arrival at my desired destination a sure thing through self-help, increased motivation, timeless success principles, and hot business opportunities. Today, those opportunities that once seemed so valid to me, I now see as only multi-billion-dollar games of chance designed to separate people from their money. The prize is always the holy grail for the greedy. Getting rich. They're games for suckers, and in those days, I was eager to play. Look around. The world is still full of carnival barkers trying to lure in the get-rich-quick crowd on the midway of life. They're just a little harder to spot. Instead of gaudy striped jackets and straw...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.